has returned. Free from their imprisonment, ancient wizard kings come, seeking lost magics and new realms to conquer, turning all whom they encounter by choice or by force. Through strife, champions arise. New unities are founded. And powerful arcane knowledge unlocked. As gods and mortals clash, the forces unleashed will shape a new age of wonders.
Welcome to Magehaven. Magehaven is a sanctuary between worlds. From here, powerful rulers called Godir venture to realms within the Astral Sea. As you conquer realms, other Godir will gather in Magehaven and join your pantheon. You will also gather pantheon experience, which unlocks new options for creating your Godir and their followers. Your pantheon will choose your destination. have the unique ability to create your empire and the people living in it. In the following steps, you will create your people, followed by your ruler. In this step, you will pick your people's culture, which defines your starting units and economy. Defines their society. your first tome of magic? What is your ruler's origin? Reveal yourself. Your journey begins. Of wonders dawns. Take some time to look around and familiarize yourself with your new surroundings. You can open the encyclopedia to find information about various units, mechanics, or... You can take a closer look at the land by zooming in, or get a better overview of the world by zooming out. Zoom out far enough to reach the open. You have reached the overview map. As you explore the world, you will have many threats and opportunities to consider. Use this to inform your strategies. You have selected one of your cities. Cities are central to your economy and allow you to build more units for your armies. Locations and province improvements, located in the city's domain, will provide you with income. Structures can be built to improve your city. Cities also recruit your units. Units cost upkeep every turn, so keep an eye on your income to ensure you can pay for your units. You have selected an army. Armies are the core of your military strength. They can explore the world, attack your foes, and defend your lands. An army is made up of individual units. You can see a unit's tier, unit role, and movement points in the army panel. Your armies can move a limited distance every turn. The distance they can move depends on the terrain they traverse. You are about to begin exploring your surroundings. While the wide world holds plenty of things to find, two of the most valuable places you can come across are free cities and ancient wonders. You have encountered a resource node. They provide additional yield to the province they are located in. Nodes are often occupied by marauders. To claim the node and its benefits, these guards will need to be removed first. You're about to enter combat. Inspect all participants and their combined strength before deciding if you want to fight manually or have your army automatically fight the battle. Welcome to the field of battle. Here, you must kill or rout your foes in order to claim victory. You have selected a unit. It has three action points to spend on moving and using abilities. This is a support unit, which can use magical abilities to heal and strengthen its allies. You have selected your ruler. Your ruler is a powerful combatant who can wield magical equipment and learn a variety of skills. This is a shield unit, a frontline melee fighter. When entering defense mode, it grants a bonus to adjacent allies protecting them against physical attacks. Ready to be cast. Spells can have a variety of powerful effects and can turn the tide of battle when used properly. Your unit is within an enemy's zone of control. When a unit moves into an enemy's zone of control, it becomes temporarily pinned and cannot move for the rest of the turn. This is a polearm unit, a frontline melee fighter. With its first strike and charge resistance abilities, it is perfectly suited for absorbing enemy melee attacks. This is a ranged unit, which excels at dealing physical damage. This unit has a ranged ability selected. Ranged abilities have an accuracy rating, which is the chance that the ability will hit the intended target. This is a skirmisher unit, which is flexible and uses both ranged and melee attacks. With its high speed and slippery ability, it is the perfect unit for hit-and-run attacks. unit just got hit by a retaliation. This happens when a melee unit is struck from within its zone of control. Your unit just attacked an enemy from behind. This is called flanking and gives a damage bonus. This unit has suffered casualties. Casualties occur when a unit takes damage, which also causes the unit to deal less damage with its attacks.